गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन चिल्ड्रन द चैप्टर इज ऑलमोस्ट कम्प्लीटेड दैट इज द एक्सप्लेनेशन पार्ट इज कम्प्लीटेड एंड नाउ वी आर हियर टू डू द एक्सरसाइजेस द फर्स्ट वन इज फिल इन द ब्लैंक्स एंड इमेज विच कैन बी ऑब्टेन्ड ऑन अ स्क्रीन इज कॉल्ड अ रियल इमेज द इमेज विच कैन बी ऑब्टेन्ड इज नोन एज real image you know very well and which cannot be obtained on a screen is the virtual image the angle of reflection dash the angle of incidence the angle of reflection is equal to angle of incidence now the incident third one The incident ray, the dash at the point of incidence and the reflected ray all lie in the same plane. The incident ray, the normal and the reflected ray all lie in the same plane. You know very well. The point, fourth one, the point where a concave mirror forms the image of a very distant object is known as the focus of the mirror. You know very well, all these things are discussed. Now, fifth one, a spherical mirror that always forms a virtual, erect and diminished image of an object is a convex mirror. Because you know that concave mirror almost forms the inverted and real image, isn't it? So here it is asking about virtual, erect and diminished image. So it is of convex mirror. Now sixth one, eye specialists use ophthalmoscope which is fitted with a concave mirror. Now children, the second one. What is the second question? Write true or false for the following statement. You have to write down true or false for the following statements. Now, you see the first one, the image formed by A plane mirror shows the right side of the object as its right side and the left side of the object as its left side. It is false. Why false? Because you have already studied that in case of plane mirror, lateral inversion phenomena takes place. That is, the right side of the object appears as the left side and the left side appears as the right side of the object. Okay, now second one is when we stand behind a pair of parallel plane mirrors, we can see an infinite number of images. It is true. Because the image formed by two mirrors, which is placed at parallel position, it forms infinite number of images. So, the statement is correct. We can take out this with the help of the formula also. That is the formula. That the image which is formed by two mirrors which is placed at angle is 360 upon x, where x is the angle which is formed by the two mirrors. So here the angle is 0, so the 360 divided by 0 will be infinite, so the statement is correct. Now third one is a concave mirror can never form a virtual image of an object. False. Why it is false? Because we know that concave mirror forms a real image, but here it is written never form. But you see children, in case when the object is placed between focus and pole, then we get a virtual image. So here it is written never, so the statement will be false. Okay, now fourth one, we can use either a concave mirror or a convex mirror as the reflector in torches. So the statement is again false. Why the statement is false? Because in convex mirror, children, you know, the image always formed is diminished, which is not suitable for torches. But in case of concave mirrors, it is used for torches because they cover a large area through reflection process. Okay, so here it is mentioned concave as well as convex, so the statement will be false because it is not true for convex mirror, because it forms diminished image. That's why it is not suitable for torches. So concave mirrors generally used in a reflector, as a reflector in a torch, but convex mirror is not used. So the statement is incorrect, that is false. Now number fifth, motor vehicles. You see, motor vehicles generally use either a plane mirror or a convex mirror as the rear view mirror. The statement is correct, so the answer will be true. Why? Because concave mirror gives an erect, virtual and full size diminished image of a distant object with a wider field of view. Thus, it enables the driver to view much larger areas. So, the statement is correct. Now, the C part, that is, tick the correct option. The first one is, the angle of incidence equals the angle between the incident ray and the normal at the point of incidence, isn't it? It is not the mirror surface, it is not the reflected ray, line inclined at 60 degree to the mirror surface. No, the angle of incidence is equal the angle of between the incident ray and the normal. So the correct option will be B, that is normal at the point of incidence. Now second one, a ray of light falling normally on a plane mirror gets reflected in such a way that it becomes parallel to the mirror surface after reflection, now makes an angle of 30 degree with the plane mirror, now makes an angle of 60 degree with the plane mirror, just retraces the path. Children, see here, a ray of light which is falling normally on a plane mirror, then it will form the same angle after reflecting from the mirror. So when it is falling normally, so it will just retrace its path. So the last option will be correct, just retraces the path. Okay, now the third one is the central point. You see, the central point of the section of the sphere which is used for making a spherical mirror is known as the central point of the section of the sphere. Now suppose that we are choosing this much section of the sphere. Okay, then the central point, what is central point known as? Hole of the mirror, center of curvature of the mirror, focus of the mirror, or midpoint of the mirror. So which will be the correct option? The central point of the section of the sphere which is used for making a spherical mirror, it is known as the pole of the mirror. So first option will be correct, that is the pole of the mirror. Now fourth one, the distance between the object and its image in a plane mirror is 6 meters. If the object moves 1 meter towards the mirror, then the distance between the object and its image will be, see children, here it is written that the distance between the object and the image. Suppose that this is the object and this is the image. So, the distance between the object and the image is 6 meter. It is 6 meter. And if the object moves 1 meter towards the mirror, it is moving, object is moving 1 meter towards the mirror. Okay. Then, the new distance between the object, then you see again the image will also move 1 meter towards the object. So what will be the actual distance? The new distance between the object and its image will be 6 minus 1 meter from this side and 1 meter from this side. That means 2 meter will be minused. Then what will be the answer? It will be 4 meter. 6 minus 2 meter will be 4 meter. So the correct option will be 4 meter. Okay? Now, the fifth and the last one. You see here, the fifth and the last one. The rear view mirror of a car is a plane mirror. Okay? A driver is reversing his car at a speed of 4 meter per second. The driver sees in his rear view mirror the image of a scooter which is parked behind his car. The scooter is parked behind his car. Okay. Now, the speed at which its image appears to approach the driver. What will be the speed at which its image is approaching? See children, as we know that the speed of the car is 4 meter per second. It is given already that the speed of a car is 4 meter per second. It is given here, and it means that the car is approaching the scooter with a speed of 4 meter per second. Clear? Now, the distance between the car and the scooter will decreases at a double rate, because we have already studied that the image, that the distance between the object and the image, if suppose that the object is moving at a speed of 1 meter, then the image is supposed to be moving at 2 meter per second. So what happens? The distance between the car and the scooter will decreases at a double rate. So, this is because the image of the scooter will travel a distance twice the distance traveled by the car in equal time. Hence, what will happen? The image of the scooter will appear to approach the driver with the speed of just double. That is, if the car is moving at a speed of 4 meter per second, then the image of the scooter will appear to approach the driver with the speed of just double, that is 8 meter per second. This will be the correct answer, that is 8 meter per second. Now we will start the D part. Yes children, see here. D part, question number 1 is, explain clearly the differences between a real image and a virtual image. Give one example of a virtual image. So the difference between a real image and virtual image is very simple children. The image which is obtained on a screen is known as real image, and which cannot be obtained on a screen is known as virtual image. Then the second difference is that the real image is formed by the actual intersection of reflected rays, whereas the virtual image is formed by the apparent intersection of reflected rays. See here, real image it is obtained on a screen and the virtual image cannot be obtained on a screen. It is formed due to the actual intersection of reflected rays and it is formed by the apparent intersection of reflected ray. Now one example also you have to give of a virtual image. See here, an example of a virtual image is when light from an object strikes a simple plane mirror. It is an example of virtual image. Okay, now we will proceed towards question number 2. How does changing the distance of the object from a convex mirror affect the size and nature of the image formed by it? Children, we had already discussed that in case of convex mirror, the object placed at a distance from the convex mirror, it does not depend upon that. Wherever the object is placed, at any place in front of the convex mirror, then the image always formed is virtual, it is always diminished, and it is, see here, the change in the distance of the object from a convex mirror does not affect the size and nature of the image formed by it. Okay, it does not depend upon the nature of the image formed by it. It does not affect it. So the image will always be virtual, erect, diminished, and between focus and pole of the mirror. This is the only case that a convex mirror forms the image. Convex mirror always form the image that is virtual, erect, diminished, and between focus and pole of the mirror. No matter where the object is placed, it does not depend upon the distance from the convex mirror and the object. Okay. Now, question number 3. You see, what is question number 3? Draw a ray diagram to show the formation of an image when the object is placed between the C, that is center of curvature, and focus of a concave mirror. So, when the object is placed at, you see, when the object here, this is the object, it is placed between C and F, that is center of curvature and focus. As usual, you see the line which is passing and it is parallel to the principal axis, always passes from the focus after reflecting from the mirror. You see the line here, it is parallel to the principal axis, after getting reflected from the mirror it passes from the focus. Okay, and here you see that the line which is coming across the focus after getting reflected from the mirror becomes parallel to the principal axis, and both the reflected rays are cutting at a point here. You see, here both the reflected rays are cutting each other, so the image formed will be beyond C. See the distance, it is beyond C, so the image will be formed here. So this will be the case when the object is placed between C and F points of a concave mirror. Now we will move towards question number 4. See here, what is question number 4? Where should we keep an object in front of a concave mirror so as to get a virtual and magnified image of it? Children, in case of concave mirror, there is only one place where the object is kept and virtual and magnified image of it is obtained. And what is that place? It is placed between focus and the pole. Okay, it is placed between the focus and the pole. So see here the answer. The object should be placed between focus and the pole of the concave mirror to get a virtual and magnified image of it. Okay, this is answer number 4. Now, fifth question. The magnified image of an object appears to be formed behind the mirror by an apparent intersection of the reflected rays. What can you say about the nature of the image? See here, the magnified image of an object appears to be formed behind the mirror by an apparent intersection of the reflected ray. What can you say about the nature of the image? The nature of the image is obviously virtual image. It will be virtual image. Why? Because it is formed behind the mirror. Okay, and the magnified, it appears to be formed. It is not it directly, it is not appearing. That is, the real image is not formed. Here it appears to be formed. So what type of image is this? It will be virtual image. Okay, and the second question is here that the type of the mirror used. It is the concave mirror. It is the concave mirror. That is the case when the concave mirror forms a, see here, in here it is the concave mirror. It forms the image in this way. See here, the virtual image is formed and it is formed behind the mirror. And what type of mirror is this? It is concave mirror. And what type of image is this? It is a virtual image. Okay, now another question, that is question number 6. Rohit suggested, see here, Rohit suggested to his father to fix a security mirror which would provide them with a wider view of the surrounding of their shop. Name the type of the mirror that Rohit must have suggested to his father. Also mention the basic characteristics of the image which is formed by this type of mirror. So Rohit must have suggested a convex mirror to his father, because the convex mirror forms a erect, virtual and diminished image, isn't it? It is used for to obtain a magnifying image. That is, a magnified image of an object is formed behind the mirror. Question number 6. That is, the Rohit suggested to his father to fix a security mirror which would provide them with a wider view of the surrounding of their shop. So it must be concave mirror in order to get, because the security mirror is made by convex mirror, because it covers the wider range, isn't it? It provides a wider view of the surrounding. That's why Rohit must have suggested a convex mirror to his father. And what are the basic characteristics of the image which is formed by this type of mirror? The basic characteristics of the image are erect, virtual and diminished. It is erect, virtual and diminished. Now, question number 7th and last of the D part. State the type of mirror that the following items, that is the object, would correspond to. First is inside of a stainless steel bowl. It will be a concave mirror. it will be a concave mirror. Then reflector of a torch, it will also be a concave mirror. Then a polished shining wooden surface, it will be a plain mirror. Then the shiny outer surface of the bicycle bell, it will be convex mirror. So see the answer. The inside of a stainless steel bowl, it will be concave mirror. Then reflector of a torch, it will be also concave mirror. Then we had already discussed these things, children, that why the reflector of a torch in such case concave mirror is used. We had already discussed. And a polished shining wooden surface, it will be plain mirror. Then the shiny outer surface of the bicycle bell, it will be convex mirror. Okay, now the D part is over. In the next class, we will do E part of the same chapter.